Whoa, hey.
Oh my goodness.
I work in IT, so I actually work in the team that supports the main IT system.
Oh, brilliant.
Oh, wow, okay.
He's still on my doorstep and I don't even know.
Yeah. Drummer and leading member of the jazz.
Give him a picture.
Oh, wow.
I'll take one. He's just chewing me down the sideboard. I'll tell you. Do you know him?
No.
I've got something on him. Give me a second. Let me just take a picture. But even down southeast, there's so many places, it's just like a swing around.
Yeah.
No, you should have.
Yeah, no.
Next week.
He's doing 75 miles.
Do you know what I mean?
Let me just get a picture of this guy, yeah. Now, what it is this guy, what does he say about him there?
Drummer and leading member of the Southern Syncopated Jazz Orchestra. I lived there between 1915 and 1917.
Together. When I was reading, I was like,
I'd like to hear
God.
Their music.
Yeah, it's
crazy because they said what had happened as the 19 people men came here to South London. It's actually noted soon after they arrived, there was loads of mixed race children.
Oh wow, that's so hard.
Yeah,
that's interesting.
Yeah.
When 18?
1888 he was born, but between 1888 or whatever when it came over, it was like what, 16 of them, and they met English women, didn't they?
So they're all black musicians.
All black musicians, travelled across Europe. All right, the next place we're going now is the the Bronze Lady. As I said,
oh my goodness, how long has this statue been there and I've never seen it?
You know what, it's been there a while. I think not long, but it's what it signifies. These are, I'm saying, these are the things we just get, we pass and we take it for granted.
Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
I don't know, but there's a lot of significance to this. Oh love, man, I'm getting there.
Ooh, Seiko.
Yeah. All right. It's in here. We got Seiko.
It's around the corner. Jason.
It's around the corner. Oh, he's gonna go around.
We're gonna go this way, yeah.
Say you did it yesterday.
Huh?
No.
Complain about cold, you don't know what cold is until you're doing 100 miles an hour.
I'm not the only one.
18.
Huh? It's funny how we take so much of these landmarks for granted and don't really...
Appreciate.
Yeah, appreciate.
No, we don't.
Me either. Yeah. Me either. My goodness. Yeah, how many people knew this was there? Because I didn't.
I didn't. Bro, as I said, some of the things I've been looking at, I don't know nothing. I was amazed. And half of them, I'm like, okay. So even some of the other ones, like you said, I want to... Eventually, I'm going to get down to it.
Yeah.
I think for our history, we need to know about these things.
Absolutely.
Give me a second. I need to just check my...
You see these, you've got, are they thermals?
Oh, these?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, no. They're actually, they were called gym bottoms or something like that.
Oh, okay.
But I just thought, just to stop them.
The initial cold, yeah. Are they working, do you think? I might have to get a bit.
I run a little bit. I'm a tropical person.
Yeah, I know the one. Me too. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't really work well under.
Yeah. Me too.
You get me?
I was even thinking of putting on like my traditional long johns to come out today, but
before getting these,
yeah.
One day I did.
Really?
That's why. That's the reason why I bought these. Because I've got some thermals.
Right? Yeah.
I used to go skiing.
Yeah.
So. The car, like it is what it is, isn't it?
Yeah.
This me, yeah, I'm just going to put them on. This me, right, they actually work. I didn't feel nothing.
Yeah.
This me, all right, then. So I went and ordered these. They only come last week, this week. So.
Where did you get them from?
No, I just bought it from Amazon.
Okay.
Yeah.
How much?
I think it was 17.50 or something.
That's
like that.
Alright.
But yeah, for what they are. Good luck.
I have to get up here, man.
I might even try and put these, put the thermals, and then put these on.
Yeah.
Because they're good, but they're adding it to a thing.
Yeah.
The thermals. These ones are still, but they're stopping, innit?
Yeah.
As soon as I'm moving.
Me, you're right,
then
yeah.
Then get hot in it, I sweat.
Yeah, me but, too, yeah.
But yeah, but this kind of riding doesn't work for me.
No, yeah.
You know, I'm saying all this out loud and I probably shouldn't be.
He's a trini, man. You know, he's a smallie.
I am too, so.
It was at this moment that William knew he fucked up.
No, me and him was just appreciating the soca music, you know? And I was thinking, what, Marcus, you don't want to borrow the speaker to pump out the soca?
Right. This is some old stuff as well, keep quiet.
Actually, I don't really like soca.
Really? I love a soca, you know?
Yeah, no, I can't. I can take it in small doses, but not the too much jump up one. Old school soca, yeah.
No, man, like, listen, I'm ready to new to soca, innit?
Hitler wanted this building as his Nazi headquarters.
Really?
It looked like
and
this
door.
Is where
it was. Yeah, it looked like
that.
The one
that
can come into
Fanta. What building is
this then? Let it hard. So, what are you talking about? During the war, when he's trying to conquer, this is what he wanted?
Yeah, he wanted to. And he was
raised
in
French
village.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and George Orwell was based on
what?
Things that happened in that building.
What
happens in this building?
Hold on.
That is called a library. So that's the University of London, UCL, Birkbeck. All of their books are kept in there. In
Listen, London has some mad history, you know?
And then, it's just a big event. They do a lot of filming in there. Batman, that sort of thing. There's
playing around.
Isn't it? Bloody hell.
That's just nice information. That's
fantastic bit of info there.
Just keep the line up over here so I can put it in front of him.
What is SOAS?
School of Arm is going to
A lot of you find a lot of people meditating out here in the evening as well. There's a lot of
hippies that
you notice.
Why? It's interesting that it's the Oriental and African studies. Why? Any insight into why that combination?
I really don't know. SOAS is quite an old school.
Yeah. No, it's more along the lines of just put it all together.
Yeah,
all in one place.
Wow.
So we've
catered
for you lot now,
innit?
All the brands
put
together.
You need to know some of your facts first, right? And your history. St. Vincent was the 200 years, you know, before they got conquered.
I was watching the Ainsley Harriet done this thing with program yesterday, and he was saying that Dominica have got the most amount of Dominica have got the most amount of centenarians, or most amount of people that are over 100 years old per capita in the world.
He's Dominican. No, I'm St. Vincent.
Oh, I thought he was Dominican.
My aunt's
Do you know what? It's a nice to be your DNA.
My brother's on it. Yeah, we are.
Okay, because I'm a king, you know.
Right, let's get this going. You guys ready?
It's Central America. Apparently, some of us come from Central America and Africa.
Jason!
And that's where...
Okay, I can explain the Central America part. Central America part, what happens is that during the 1890s, so a lot of the West Indians went to Panama to help. They were like doctors, labourers.
When? 18?
No, the end of 18.
So what about the
15? The
15. I'm interested in what you're saying. I need to know.
I've got loads of books.
So that's kind of like a wind rush before a wind rush, sort of.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I read the old almanac.
Yeah.
And Cuba.
Yeah. Again, Cuba is for the farming.
That's where my grandfather.
Yeah.
Look at his grumpy weight.
But you know what, when I was looking at him yesterday, yeah, what they were saying, yeah, as much as his professional career was only 4 years, what's made this guy stand out, again, just like those other people, the way he's done these electric guitars, nobody's been able to replicate what he's done on the electric guitar. Who's... No, we got everybody.
Oh, sorry.
You mean Jason?
Thank you, sorry.
No, don't worry. We weren't losing, maybe customer service. Listen, see this, yeah? I'm gonna read something about this was serious. These men here, they wanted, it's only thing, it's only one black guy.
Really?
Yeah. But I think what happened was, right, I need my brakes to be working like that now. I've got, my disc ones have worn out. I've got to take it to the shop now.
Because I can't. You know if they're mechanical, you've got to keep adjusting them, yeah?
No, I don't think they're mechanical. They're just hydraulic. Really? Yeah. But not, you know, if you can get, I think I've got the cheaper version of hydraulic.
Okay, wait, so this one I definitely wouldn't have found on my own.
No, but Jason, yeah. This
just
one.
My local walks.
Listen, you see this one here? I had to literally get the URL for this one. The internet, just because this one is serious. And there was something that the black guy said when they took him to court. But he still got killed with another six, and the rest of them got taken to Australia. Right, let me give you a little picture about this.
Please.
Now.
Picture.
All right, so again, this is a bit long.
Okay.
Go for it.
I've got no idea what this is.
Okay, so listen, at the end of the 18th century and in the first three decades.
Worry?
carry on. He has to wait.
Oh, whatever, man.
Go.
All right, so. At the end of the 18th century and in the first three decades of the 90s, Britain was still predominantly agricultural. But society was changing. Rural living was giving way to.
See food there?
Huh?
See food there?
Where?
Uber Eats. Yeah, come keep name Ed, I'm taking food.
Marcus is the youngest here.
Yeah, he's baby man.
All right, let's
and he
do
knows
this.
So much! And he knows so much!
So who's the oldest there then?
I don't want to say, it might be our Lloydie.
What? Lloyd or Genie?
Yeah.
Sorry, thank you. Oh, it's right here.
Yeah.
Do you know, you see when he was in this country here, this is how he earned his money to buy his freedom back in America. Because obviously he was a runaway slave and stuff. But again, I can't do Frederick Douglass justice, so I didn't take up too much information, because these men is, you know, there was a book I read back in the day where he explains how slaves were getting shot in their faces and also...
You know this house costs millions, innit?
Yeah, man.
It must do. Just for the fact it's... Never mind the fact that it's... apart from the fact we're in... Where are we? In Chelsea.
Fulham, Chelsea.
The fact that it... Marley used to live here. Now imagine being the owner of this house and having random people pitching up outside your house all the time.
They leave now, but their family home is the home where the autumn pen lives.
Oh, really?
And they just got back outside, they said they had lodge, but it's going to go out nowhere, like in the country, lane somewhere. Wow. Then again, it could be mandatory to cover the cameras like outside their house.
And they're all right about it.
Yeah.
We'll be right back. Lights are red, lights are red.
Oh, whoa, 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 hey, 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 hey.
Oh my goodness.
What's that all about?
I've never seen a cemetery so densely populated.
That's what I'm saying, man. I want to know what the significance of this cemetery is.
Yeah.
It's like, there was one time I did, I just rode out and did a couple of like St. Paul's, and when I started to catch up, St. Paul's, Westminster Abbey.
Yeah.
And there's so many things in this vast space.
Yeah.
But you're right though, isn't it?
No, it's this, it's literally nowhere to, you can barely...
Look, Ambrose, that's got to be a black man.
Do you remember when I used to love you? Oh, this has been fantastic, man. This has been fantastic. Really enjoyed it.
Yeah, so I've done it yesterday by myself.
I'm yeah.
With people,
yeah.
Behind.
Yeah.
It's taking a little longer with people because of the stuff and stuff. But this is what I like doing the group rides, man. Like,
yeah.
You get out, you meet people.
Yeah.
You go to places you never even
dreamed. Exactly, because the amount of times I've driven past like where Marcus Garvey lived.
And never know.
But you never know.
Never. I think when I was younger, we were in the airport run.
Yeah.
Yeah,
exactly. That's what I'm saying. The amount of times I've done this airport run, not only by my, you know, on my own or with family, but even growing up as a little boy.
Yeah.
And at once did any of my I don't even think they would have known, any of my grandparents or aunts or uncles or parents would have known that that's where Marcus Garvey
as
lives.
As I said, brother, there's four. We've only done. I've excluded about four. There's 46 locations.
I'm up for the rest of them.
And they're just this. You'd be like, okay, but they're clear across London now.
Right,
I don't know if
we'll
make
you
do this, guys. We're
going to
be cheeky, yeah?
Right, let's go.
No, because you know what? I went down to Slimmer Tires. But after a week, I went right back to my normal tyres. I'm feeling everything.
Where it is as well, especially with these ones, how they're gator, innit? Uh-huh. So there's not as much air in it. Like a lot of it is just solid. Mm. You know what I mean? So I feel it more, but really, I would say I feel it on any.
When we get to the next stop, yeah? Right, this bike, yeah?
Yeah.
Just see what I mean.
I feel it.
What I felt though, I don't think I would feel it on any bike.
Really?
I'm talking like, you know, like certain country lanes where it's all bitty.
Yeah.
Them drains and whatnot. Because certain times I just ride like normal cars, all of a sudden, pothole. I just stay like this now. Because that's what keeps you on the bike. Yeah, you know.
What PSI do you, are those, what makes me pumped up to?
Oh, I've never even
they were. I think they're about 40. They should be about 40.
See, mine, these are, they have to be at least 100.
100?
Yes, 100. Yeah, they're 100. So I always make sure that, it's meant to be 110, but I always make sure that at least 100.
When I did mine the other day, yeah, I did mine. Mine's meant to be 40 for comfortability. Uh-huh. I did mine to 60 because I wanted speed.
Yeah. I think that's part of the reason why for a small bike they have got a little bit of speed on them still. Yeah. But
and you know what as well? It's a commuter bike.
Yeah.
It allows you to basically go over 90% of the surfaces.
Yeah, exactly. I got work to do. world to do.
Yeah, you good, yeah?
Bless you, man. Lovely to meet you.
Thank you.